Hey, it's Mark Podolsky, Land Geek, with your favorite niche real estate website, www.thelandgeek.com. And on this week's Roundtable Podcast, we don't have all the usual suspects, but we've got one of the usual suspects, the technician, landopia.com, Eric Peterson. Eric, how are you?
I'm good. Happy to be here today.
Happy to have you. I can't tell you how excited I am that you and Tate have a new course coming out. And one of the pieces that you're doing is never lose a lead again. I'm not going to spoil it, but it's basically going to be one of those courses that really make you money, which leads me to, speaking of making money, She Makes It Rain, the most feared woman in the country, the terrorist hunter, Mimi Schmidt. Mimi, how are you?
I'm doing great. How are you, Mark?
Pulse is still normal. Respiration's fine. Always happy to see you on the round table. And of course we've got, I love it when you call me Big Papa, Tate Litchfield. Tate, how are you?
I'm fantastic.
You know, I love the fact that, you're just so transparent about what you're doing. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, check out Lots. Just go to landgeek.com/lots, look over Tate's shoulder and learn more. And, should you give them a little sneak peek about the course coming up?
Let's just say you're not going to want to miss it, because Eric and I are putting a lot of time into it, and we plan on tackling one of the biggest problems that we as land investors face. And that's not only how to sell land, but how to follow up effectively and correctly with your leads that you generate, because we've noticed that people's sales are falling through the cracks. And so this course is designed to prevent that from happening again.
Absolutely. I can't tell you how excited I am for this thing to come out, which will be very soon. We're just putting the finishing touches on it, and it's going to be amazing. In fact, it's going to be so amazing, we guarantee it. It's just going to make you money. Guaranteed. Last but not least, the brain, the professor, Scott Todd, scotttodd.net. landmodo.com. You're not automating your Craigslist and your Facebook postings. postingdomination.com/thelandgeek. Get smarter, get wiser. investorninjas.com. Scott Todd, how are you?
Mark, I'm great. How are you?
I'm a little salty this afternoon, I'll tell you. A little salty.
Okay. Yeah.
Just based on the topic.
Oh.
You know, like, there's just a lot of stuff out there that just kind of rubs me the wrong way. But when you hear the topic, you'll see why it kind of rubs me the wrong way. The mischaracterization of things. So Scott Todd, tell us about our topic today.
So, you know, Mark, I've been talking to people, I've been listening to people. And, you know, one of the things that often comes up is, like, I think people are afraid to come to boot camp. Why? Because I think that they feel like it might be a sales pitch, a pitch fest, a sales machine. You know, they're going to get drug out of the room. They're going to have to, like, go into, like, a beat up room, and they're going to get harassed to, like, do something more. And I hear this and it breaks my heart, because, like, I don't know, I've been going to boot camp since 2015, February 2015. So 5 years now, man. Like, 5 years of going to boot camps, and I've never seen anybody drug out of the room and beat up in the back room. Like, either this is really happening and I'm just oblivious to it, or there's more going on at boot camp than what people think.
Yeah, so I think it's a really good topic, sort of this myths versus facts. And I know that if you go to other real estate seminars or just other seminars in general, it can be a pitch fest. There's good information, but typically the idea in the typical seminar business is, we're going to give you 2 hours of information for free. But if you want the real information, spend $2,000 and come to this 3-day event. So then they go and they spend 3 days in a room. There's salespeople in the room. And then after that, if you really want to do well, then, you know, invest in this $100,000 coaching program that puts you 3 days on a bus and you look at a bunch of houses. So that is the seminar model. We do the exact opposite. So Eric Peterson, what was your first experience? I mean, at bootcamp, were you sort of expecting, I mean, look, guilty as charged. I send out a lot of emails. You can listen to the podcast. I'm not shy about promoting what we have because I truly believe in it. And if I don't say anything, no one's going to know about flight school. No one's going to know about the toolkit. No one's going to know about coaching, but it's because I believe in it. That being said, I don't certainly want to spend 2.5 days upselling because it ruins it for me. It ruins it for the attendees. It ain't no fun for anybody. So what really goes on, Eric?
Yeah. So I was thinking back as we're talking here about my first time at boot camp, which was also back in 2015 at some point. And, you know, I didn't have a history of going to other real estate seminars, so I don't think I really knew what could happen, I guess, or what I should expect to have happen. I was familiar with going to different conferences that I paid a lot of money for that were there to educate me in my field at the time, which was graphic design. So, you know, I'd pay thousands of dollars to attend these conferences and hear different people speak and things like that. So that's kind of what I was familiar with. And I guess that was kind of my expectation coming to boot camp is that, you know, I'm going to learn. Well, I got there and, you know, that's indeed what happened. I did learn. At the time I had the toolkit and I can remember, you know, day one going through more deals than I could handle and learning about county research, learning about buying properties and so on. And then through the weekend, I remember following through the rest of the process. Now, you know, I never felt any pressure to buy coaching, to buy anything else while I was at boot camp. That was something I later decided to do, but it wasn't because I was at boot camp and they're like, you know, I was told that if I didn't pay X amount of money, you know, I wouldn't learn this important thing about the business or something like that. So, yeah, I mean, it's just very educational. It's really helpful. The community, that the people you get to meet are invaluable as you learn and grow your business. And I'd say, you know, from when I started going to boot camp to where we are today, just night and day. I mean, we're offering more and more value every time. So I can't say enough great things about it.
Yeah, I mean, I can't remember because it was so long ago, but was I nice to you?
You know what? I think, I don't remember if it was my first or second boot camp, but back then you used to give away a property and I won a free property at boot camp. I thought that was the coolest thing in the world.
Wow. That I forgot about that. Yeah, we used to do that. That is really cool. Mimi Schmidt, you are like the boot camp queen.
I love boot camp.
So what was your expectations coming in? What was the reality?
Oh, it way surpassed my expectations. I guess I felt I was going to be upsold, right? That there would be a lot of pressure and I was determined I wasn't going to spend any money. But I ended up, gosh, I think I went to 8 boot camps in my first year and a half. I never felt pressure to buy anything. The reason I went into coaching for a year and a half is because I realized when I got back on my own that I wanted to accelerate the rate that I was going at. And not only do I not feel like it's this pressure to buy, I feel the exact opposite. It's kind of like a safe place where I go to build my network so that when I go through dips, I have people to lean on. Do you guys remember the guy from Florida at the Orlando boot camp that was only going to give me cash? And as a woman alone, I was supposed to go meet him. You guys were
all come
with me. He ended up coming and I thought, oh my gosh, can't have a man I don't know meet me in hotel room. You know, you guys help walk me through how the deal was supposed to go. And it was so friendly and it was awesome. So I learned so much at boot camp. Even still as a coach, I learned so much at boot camp, and I hate to miss it. But for me, it's the best part of our network is going to boot camp. So I just think it's invaluable if you're in our community to experience it.
Mark, I take back what I said. That was the only boot camp that I remember where we took that guy in the back room and, you know, like shook him down for the money.
Yeah, I do. I remember that, but there's a good reason. It was for Mimi. Yeah.
For Mimi. Yeah, we shook him down.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, deservedly so. Right. It's not that we're not capable of doing it. We can do it.
Yeah. Don't mess with us.
We choose not to.
We're the land geeks. Not to.
Yeah, absolutely. So, I mean, Scott, your first boot camp, what were your expectations? What was the reality?
You know, I thought that boot camp was I was kind of bracing myself for like the sell, right? Like I really was bracing myself for the sell because I had been to real estate convention or real estate boot camps before or whatever. I've been to those, and you know, I was bracing myself. And then, you know, when I walked in, I mean, my first boot camp was in Scottsdale. It was February. It was beautiful, man. Like the weather was beautiful. I mean, it was like great temperature, and nice hotel. Get there, walk into the room, and like there's 35 people there. And I'm looking around like, okay, this is interesting. And then we start off doing a deal, right? Like you start off with education. And like the weekend just did not stop with education. You know, and then unlike other boot camps, you had interactive sessions, right? Like think about that for a minute. You know, on each day of boot camp, there is an interactive session where you pair up with a team and go work. Why is that? Well, it's because it's education, right? Because you learn in group, you learn by doing, and that's what boot camp is about. Like it's about you getting the knowledge, the confidence, the skills that you might be missing. And then the cool thing is that, yeah, there's a networking hour. We used to do it one time. Now we do it on two days, Friday and Saturday night. So it's really the whole boot camp experience is really about, one is about sharing education and sharing kind of next steps. It's really about connecting you with other people that are doing what you're doing. And, you know, like everybody said, like if there's another step that someone wants to take, well, then that's on them. But ultimately, you can walk out of boot camp, and we've seen people do this. Like we just had someone on the round table last week, Joey, who went through flight school. He went to boot camp. Look at Joey, man. What, $13,000 of passive income? That's huge.
Yeah.
He's doing it.
And at no point did we try to shake Joey down, because you can't really see in the podcast, but, you know, Joey's jacked. Like that's not a guy to mess with.
Yeah.
Right. Wow. Tate, what about you? What was your first boot camp experience like? And you're so young. I don't even know if you've ever even been to a real estate seminar.
Yeah. I mean, attending real estate seminars was not something I'd done prior. I've attended some since getting involved in this and been unimpressed, honestly. But I'll be, maybe I'm the exception here, but I've spent plenty of money at boot camps. I've spent thousands of dollars at boot camps, but it was never giving you money. I was buying property the whole time I was there. People coming to me saying, hey, you want to buy this property? It's like, show me the number. Yep, that's mine. Next person, get in line. What do you got? Uh-huh. Yeah, I'll take that too. I've spent plenty of money at boot camps and I love it. And going to boot camps, like Mimi mentioned, it's about that community. It's about growing your social network within this land business, because I'll be honest, it's a lonely world as a land investor. It's not like there's a ton of people who relate to what we do out there. And if you're a full-time investor, you need that camaraderie. This podcast right here, it's, you know, it's kind of for our own benefit. We like getting on. We like shooting the breeze with one another. We like chatting and we like kind of sharing ideas, and it's good for all of us and our mental health. So boot camp's kind of like that quarterly checkup that you can have where you can show up, meet people who are just obsessed, just as obsessed as you are about raw land in the middle of nowhere, and understand what your goal is with it. So, yeah, I mean, the people that don't want to come, I think they don't want to come because they're afraid of that sales pitch. And you know what? It's just not there. I mean, we're informative. We let you know what we offer. But at the same point, if you don't want to do it, that's okay. We're not going to be enemies. We're okay with it. We're cool.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, I think that the Trojan horse for bootcamp, honestly, like we give you a lot. It's 2.5 days of education. 15 minutes of it is me talking about coaching. Literally, of 2.5 days, 15 minutes of it is coaching, and you just apply. Like, that's it. There's no sales team in the back. No one's going to shake you down. And it's just very, very easy going. But the Trojan horse for me is the community. And I'm going to date myself here. I grew up in St. Louis. I literally knew all my neighbors. I knew the parents. I knew the kids. We would go out. My parents were like, okay, be home by 6. They had no idea where I was. And if I was hungry, I would just go over to the neighbor's house. Literally, like, they were like, feed me. My kids don't have that. I don't have that. I don't know my neighbors in my own neighborhood. But, and then there's that Mrs. Boxerman. She's like older, like you kind of, she's like watching everything and kind of telling you like, don't do this, don't do that. Like you kind of knew like, uh-oh. But you kind of like didn't like her, but you loved her because she was always looking out what was best for the neighborhood. And we don't have that anymore. But what we do now have is this community of like-minded investors where everyone's looking out for everyone else. You know, you don't get the sense that it's like this predatory type of situation where, you know, Matt Forbes is coming in and be like, hey, what land are you going to sell me? Like, no, he's like, you go up to Matt, like, and certainly he'll have a drink in his hand, but he'll be like, hey, how can I help you? It's literally, how can I help you? What can I do for you? What are you struggling with? What are you doing well? Like, we're all there to help. There's no sort of scarcity mentality. It's all abundance mentality. And it's amazing to watch. And I mean, obviously, selfishly, I love seeing you guys, but just seeing the attendees and answering those questions at the networking hour or during the breaks, in just one little thing can literally transform someone's business. And people like Mimi that keep coming back, like, yeah, the content may not be that much different from the first time, but you're different every single time you come to bootcamp because you're in a different place in your business. So in the first bootcamp, it might just be about county research and deal flow. By your fourth bootcamp, it might just be about the systems and automation. And can I get a zap automation from Eric during the break? Or, you know, VA management from Mimi? Or, you know, Scott Todd might really just throw out that one magical phrase that you weren't using to close deals. And now you're hearing it and seeing it in real time. There's nothing, to my knowledge, like it, where the focus is on education and on community. And we let you go. I've had consultants tell me, Mark, you're crazy. You should be selling at these things and doing these things that everyone else does. I'm like, no, I don't want to. I just don't. It's not fun for me. It's not going to be fun for the attendee. And, you know, if they want to accelerate, they can. We let them know this is there, but there's no pressure to do it for sure. And that's certainly not the focus at all. Eric, do you agree?
I completely agree. I mean, it's definitely not the focus to sell. The focus is about education. It's about community. And, you know, I think in general, if you talk to people that have been to boot camp, they're going to have that same response.
Do you know your neighbors?
Do I know my neighbors?
Yeah, you just moved into a new house. Do you know, see?
I know one, like, actually.
You know one neighbor. So, like, it used to be, you move into a new house, all the neighbors come by, they say hi, what can we do, how can we help you? They bake brownies and cookies, and they get to know your kids. And it's not like that anymore. But we sort of go old school at boot camp. I mean, we get to know, we try to get to know everybody. I mean, there's literally, I mean, I literally will make it a point to try to say hello to everyone and talk with them and try to get to know them on a personal basis at boot camp. And it's not just all about land investing necessarily. Gosh, Jeff Jones was at a boot camp. We had like a mutual friend. It was really weird. It's kind of crazy. Mimi, how about you? What's your, I mean, are we exaggerating the power of the community?
No, not at all. I love this. I love the community, right? And it's just celebrate your wins. You get support for the dips. You find out about the technology and the way it's changing instead of on your own. You find out the new Craigslist or the most recent Facebook change, right, at boot camp and how to get over it. Right? All of our minds together that are stronger than if we were doing this individually. So, yeah, I can't imagine our group without boot camp.
Yeah.
Yeah, Eric? And the amount, and you're right, there's so much more information, Eric, you were saying, than the way it was 4 or 5 years ago, right? There's so much more that we talk about and share with each other. So it's interesting the way it's been evolving. It's good.
Oh yeah, it's Kaizen. It's continual improvement. Every single bootcamp gets better and better. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, because we really take to heart on the surveys, what people say and how we can improve. And we just, Oh, that's a great idea. And we do it. So I'm really excited for the Phoenix bootcamp.
Even the programs, they're becoming so much more customized. Used to be one program, right? Now we have a lot of different programs that are customized for people and where they are in their businesses.
Yeah, the VIP room is relatively new compared to where we started.
VIP room, we had the Lanky VAs for a while. There are all these different programs that have come out of it in the last couple of years that didn't, right? Geek Pay didn't exist when I started. So a lot of technology. Yeah,
LG Pass didn't exist when you started.
Yep.
Yeah. Tate, do you know your neighbors?
I do, yeah.
You do know your neighbors. Look at that.
Yeah. I don't know all of them. I don't know the people kind of behind us, but the ones in front of us, yeah, we know them. It's not like I've had dinner with them or anything like that, but we're friendly. We wave and those kind of things.
When you moved to the neighborhood, though, were there people coming up, introducing, baking goods?
No, it's mainly kind of been over the years, seeing them outside, introducing ourselves. I wanted to know my neighbors because, you know, when we travel, I like to say to them, hey, if you notice anything going on at my house, give me a call kind of thing. So we have a good relationship with them, but, you know, it's very, I don't know. It's very basic, I should say. We watch out for each other.
Yeah, but since you're at home all the time, are you like the Mrs. Boxerman of the neighborhood?
Yeah, I mean, I love yelling at kids. It's like my favorite thing. Get off this property. Hey, keep it down out there. It's 7:30. You know, that's me.
Yeah, yeah. Focus on your studies, kids.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah. Mimi, do you know your neighbors?
Yeah, don't get me started. We have our sheriff lives two doors down and has a Friday porch party every Friday. Well, I know all our neighbors. I mean, yeah, like too much sometimes. I have a good neighbor. We have a good neighbor network. We help each other out.
Yeah. I think the pendulum has swung too far.
Sidewalks and that. Yeah, we help each other out. And we have Super Bowl parties and things, all kinds of fun stuff together.
Yeah. See, it used to be like my big fat Greek wedding where everyone's in everyone's business and it could feel stifling. But I'd rather have that than just like the wave and not know.
Honestly, I don't like it when other husbands talk to me in front of their wives and say embarrassing things. Hey, how's it going? Like, your wife's right there, dude. I don't like that. So I.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. I mean, I get that. There's always the creepy neighbor, but you're going to have that. That's just society in general.
Yeah.
They've got to deal with their wife.
Right. And be like, it's a great group. They just have to watch how many they have at the porch party on Friday night.
Yeah, exactly. It's like the Mimi 2 drink limit in the neighborhood. then you cut off for sure. Scott Todd, how about you? Is there anything about boot camp and the community that you want to add that nobody's mentioned?
No, I think it's a pretty relevant point, right? Like, it's not just about, there's a reason why people who go to boot camp, like, you see them, right? Like, they've been to boot camp before. Whenever I start a boot camp, in the instruction, I always ask, how many of you have been to boot camp before? Hands go up, right? Like, there's a reason why people come back. And, you know, I'd love to say that it's because of our great education that we're sharing with them. But, like, honestly, if you tell the same joke all the time, they have to be coming back for your joke. That's the only reason I can think of.
It's not a good joke.
Really the education.
Look, the joke lands every time.
They're good.
But they've heard them. So, you know, it's not because of they're not looking for new material from Mark. I'm no Louis C.K.
I think it's good.
Yeah. Louis C.K. is a comedian he sort of revolutionized stand-up in the sense that he would always do a new act, which for the longest time no one really did because it's so hard to come up with new material. And he kind of put that pressure on them to do that. Let alone he did get in trouble. So I'm no Louis C.K. in two respects. But, I mean, I feel like the round table, like, you know, you've got to go to thelandgeek.com/bootcamp and watch the videos, and hear what other attendees have said. The Facebook reviews, people talk about bootcamp. Nowhere is there, no one has ever said to us, you know, during bootcamp, boy, wish you guys provided more information, less salesiness, ever. It's just not what we want to do. And it's not fun for you. It's not fun for us. So that is the fear. If your fear is you're going to come to boot camp and it's going to be all about the upsell, it's going to be all about us and not about you, I get it. I understand it. But do additional research, and I can guarantee you that will not be your experience at all. Granted, you know me. I am going to promote. It's going to be 15 minutes in 2.5 days. If you can't stomach 15 minutes of me talking about that, then I don't know. But if you can, and again, it's not that bad. No one's pressuring you. It's just a little presentation. And if you want to do it, you apply. If you don't, you know, we go on to the next module, and you're not literally going to feel any pressure at all while you're there. You will feel pressure to have a drink with Matt Forbes, but that's about it.
Mark, the other thing I would say is this. A lot of times people think like, oh, well, man, it's expensive to get on a plane and go, right? Like I've seen that before, right? Like I can tell you firsthand, it's expensive for you not to get on that plane and go. However you're gonna get there, right? Like you're paying one way or the other. You're paying by selling yourself short of one, knowledge and context, because look, you can't get everything from home. You can't get everything in your own little bubble. Get out of your bubble. Go meet new people. Go experience something new. Go see a new city. Guess what? If you're doing the land business, it's a tax write-off. Like go enjoy it. I guarantee you that, you know, you can do it. You can do it affordably. And like, I can tell you, it's always been profitable for me. All the tips that I get, whatever, all the contacts, it's always been a profitable experience. Go do it.
Yeah. I mean, I learned something new every single boot camp as well. Everyone does. I mean, the room does become smarter than any just one person, because we do tap into that collective intelligence. It's pretty amazing. So again, just go to thelandgeek.com/bootcamp. And speaking of selling, by the way, you know we have a thing called Flight School? If you want to learn more, just go to landgeek.com/training. See how Scott Todd can take you up that land investing mountain over 16-week period, safely, quickly, and efficiently. It is transformative. If there's anyone else to emulate in this business, it's got to be Scott Todd. Flight School is absolutely amazing. Don't take my word for it, though. Listen to the testimonials. We guarantee you the education is not going to cost you anything. We have a 180-day guarantee that you will make back the Flight School investment. Simply follow the recipe. Show us your work. Prove to us that you're doing it. It's not literally going to cost you anything. We guarantee it. All right. We're at that point now, Mimi Schmidt, where I get to pick on you and ask you for your tip of the week, a website, a resource, a book, something actionable for the Art of Passive Income listeners to go and do, improve their businesses, improve their lives. What have you got?
Okay. I'm geeking out today. I'm going back to my data roots. So I found Zillow has a research data site that where you can download Zillow sales data. So I've gone out there and I downloaded the monthly home sales number. And what I found in there, if I download it by like city, inside counties, it'll tell me how the different areas inside the county are doing, whether they're, because some are more popular, right, or selling more than others. So I thought that was interesting when I was looking at new counties. And also, this is under the inventory listings and sales section. There's also the average days on Zillow. So I can download days on Zillow by county. And I found it interesting. I was looking at the average number of days by county. And the counties that I'm in that were oversaturated, the average days on Zillow was over 100. And the ones that aren't as saturated was under 100. And so as I'm looking at new counties to go in, I was using that days on Zillow as just a check. I can go check it super easy, super fast, and see how quickly properties are selling in that county in comparison to other counties. So there are a couple of good metrics in there that I thought were really useful. Even just like in the monthly sales, I can get the seasonality for a particular county, right? So when it's fast, you know, so let's say I want to rev up my inventory buying because I know summer in a particular county's hot, right? So it kind of helps me with those type of things.
This is really cool. Okay, so I'm on the data. It shows home values, rentals, inventory listings, and sales. Is that where I want to go?
Yeah, that section.
And then I go to days on Zillow.
Days on Zillow, and then on geography, choose county.
Choose my county, and I can download.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to download. And then I'm going to open it. This is really great information. I wish you didn't tell Eric about this. This is fantastic.
So it's got a lot of historical information. So you can see trends, right? If the inventory is getting heavy and it's slowing down, or if it's getting faster, right? Because the economy is so hot. So that was useful.
Hey, what do you think?
I like it. I'm thinking right now. It's cool.
This is super geeky.
So of course it has houses in it too, but it's going to give you a general trend if an area is hot or not.
Yeah. I mean, I love it. Eric Peterson, what do you think?
Yeah, you know, Mimi told me about this like 3 months ago. So her and I have been using this ever since, and it's great.
You have any kind of automation baked in with this? Is there an API or a Zap?
I'm not spending that much time on it. I'm downloading the data, and it's like a quick reference, like in a checklist of things I do when I'm looking at new counties. Right, I'm not getting lost in the data, I promise, Scott.
All right.
All right, Scott.
I'm laughing because Eric said he's had it for 3 months. I've had it for 5. Mimi showed it to me back last summer. So where you been, man? Tell you how long you had it.
A while. It's a cool tool.
He lost count.
Tate had it so long ago, he's just wondering why we're just slowly catching up.
I've had it so long that I forgot I had it, and now I'm playing with it again. And I'm like, oh, yeah, this thing actually is sweet.
Oh, yeah. I'm back to this thing.
Yeah, like, yeah, I'm using this.
It's like one of Daisy's toys.
Yeah.
Like, she's got so many of them, she forgot.
Rotate.
He got lost under the couch.
There it is. Very cool. Well, I want to thank the listeners and just remind you that the only way that we're going to continually motivate Mimi to continue with these tips of the week, if you do us three little favors, you got to subscribe, you got to rate, you got to review the podcast, send us a screenshot of that review to support@thelandgeek.com. We're going to send you for free the $97 passive income launch kit course, as well as the latest wholesaling course, how to double your money 30 days or less. I really thought today's topic, which on the outset could sound a little self-serving because we're talking about our own bootcamp, is really important that we differentiate the myths of bootcamp versus the reality of bootcamp. And certainly, like Scott said, you don't want to have static information. If you're just sitting there with a toolkit and you haven't come to bootcamp, well, the toolkit's recorded at one point in time. And all the things that are current in the marketplace, we do discuss at bootcamp. And, you know, one of the favorite modules is just Mimi's Facebook module, because Facebook marketing is constantly changing. And we constantly are seeing that on the surveys, along with all the other things that we're constantly improving on and doing. So don't miss out. Learn more. Go to thelandgeek.com/bootcamp. All right, Tate, are we good?
We're good.
Eric, are we good?
Doing good.
Mimi?
Great.
Scott Todd?
We're good, Mark.
All right, let's do this. One, two, three. Let freedom ring.
Mark, I'm telling you, this is the third one in a row. We are on to it.
Scott and I are synced up.
We are. I got the magic cure for it, guys. I figured out how to do it. It's only taken 4 years, but I got it.
Do tell.
Okay, here's the deal. When Mark does his countdown, one, two, three, what you got to do is you got to bring up another window on your computer so that you can't see his lips. Okay, like you can look at his hair, but don't look at his face. Listen to him as he's doing the 3, 2, 1, and just let it go, and it will be very natural. It's when we're watching him that it just gets messed up. That's the secret.
Okay. Worth a try.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, I finished a great book this weekend.
What?
American Dirt.
Oh, really?
Oh, my gosh. Really, really a fun read. Good read.
Did you watch that movie I told you to watch?
I looked for it. The Peanut Butter and the Falcon?
Oh, it's so good.
The Peanut Butter Falcon. Who said that? Was Tate? Was that your commissioner?
Dude, it's not on Netflix. I looked at it. I looked for it today.
You have to buy it.
Have to buy it.
Well, like you have to rent it. It's no big deal for you, Mark. It's like $6.
You know what I did rent on Friday was Parasite. Holy cow! First of all, I picked up a lot of Korean. Annyeonghaseyo, gamsahamnida. Annyeonghaseyo.
But it was good.
That being said, it was really, really well done.
All I know is the peanut butter.
You leave that movie a little disturbed.
Yes.
The Peanut Butter Falcon, you leave feeling good. It's a happy movie.
I'm telling you, man, Tate said that at boot camp. I got home, I'm like, I don't know. And then I'm like, all right, I just got to go with it. Like, it is the one movie where I, like, literally put down the iPad or anything else, computer, and I just watched it. And I'm like, wow. And then it was over, and I'm like, it can't be over. And so then my wife's like, let's go to the extra clips or whatever. Next thing you know, I'm, like, watching the backstory behind the movie. I don't do that. Like, I'm like, this is really good.
Wow. It's worth watching. It's worth probably buying, honestly. It was that good.
Is it like one of like a Shawshank? Like when he's watching over and over and over?
It says the sweetest darn film of the decade at the top of the
list. This movie is great. And I used Tate's tip of the week just from a few weeks ago, the app that says just watch, Mark. I just went and looked. And sure enough, it says you got to rent it. So I should have looked at that yesterday when I gave you advice.
Okay, no worries. Eric, are you in?
Yeah, I might have to check it out. Is it kid friendly?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Kids will love it.
Yeah, there wasn't anything, you know, bad about it. It's a good movie.
Mimi, are you in?
Yeah, I'm always looking for good new stuff to watch.
All right, the three of us will watch it, and then we'll do our review. We'll be like the Siskel and Ebert of Land Geek.
Okay.
Although, am I the only one that's seen Parasite? I'd love to hear what you guys thought of Parasite.
Yeah, I haven't seen it.
Oh, man.
I know it won some awards. It won an award, right?
It won Best Picture. It won Best Director.
I mean, I don't
it won
watch
Best
those.
Screenplay.
I don't watch. I don't need a bunch of people telling me which movies I like already. I mean, I don't need that. But if it's a good recommendation from you guys, I'll check it out. Parasite.
Yeah, I think there's something to that. I mean, not every year does the Academy get the Best Picture right. I agree. But it was really, I mean, it was really good. I thought Once Upon a Time in Hollywood was great.
Oh, that was fantastic.
So I don't know.
No movie I rewatched over the weekend.
What?
Ready Player One.
So good. Yeah.
I love it. And then they'll come out with Ready Player Two coming soon.
The book or the movie?
The book.
Oh, good. Ooh, that book was so good.
Apparently, it's going to go Ready Player Two and Ready Player Three, and I'm sure that there'll be movies too.
Oh, for sure. Okay.
All right. So my three top fiction books for the past 2 years are going to be Ready Player One, is number one, The Martian is number two, and then American Dirt is number three. But it's a little early to start doing our summer reading list.
Yeah.
For sure. All right. Well, thanks, everybody. And see everyone next week.